Hi students, let us discuss about the characteristics of the Asclepiadaceae family. Habitat: most of these plants are xerophytic plants. Only one plant is grown as epiphytic plant, that is Decidia. Beside the picture, see the beside picture, this is Decidia. This Decidia is grown as a epiphytic plant. What is mean by epiphytic plant? Some plants are grown on the another largest plants. The type of plants are known as epiphytic plants. The epiphytic plants best example to the Asclepiadaceae family is Decidia. This is Decidia. Okay. Next one is, one plant is grown as Sarcolobus. Second picture is Sarcolobus. This Sarcolobus is grown as halophytic, plant. Halophytic means which plants are grown in salt conditions. Those plants are known as Sarcolobus. That Sarcolobus is second picture. This is the habitat. Most of these plants are grown as xerophytic. Only Decidia is epiphytic and Sarcolobus is halophytic. Next, habit. Habit is perennial herbs are present in this family. Example is Asclepias, and calotropy species are shrubs. This is the habit. Next, going to the vegetative characteristics. Vegetative characteristics, nothing but root, stem and leaves. Root, these are the dicotyledons. So these plants are having the taproot system. Only Decidia is consisting the adventitious roots. Why? Because already I told in habitat character, Decidia is grown as epiphytic. That's why this Decidia plant has adventitious roots. Then stem characteristics. In the stem, these plants are aerial, erect, weak stem, aerial erect stems are. But in Leptodynia, already we know Leptodynia common name in Telugu, Mukkutummurtiga. That's why this Leptodynia has weak stem. Next one is Sarcostemma. Sarcostemma has succulent stem. See the picture. That is Sarcostemma. Appearance like casuarina. So this is appearance like casuarina. This Sarcostemma is succulent stem, has succulent stem. This is the stem characters. Along with these characters, tuberous stem also present in this family. Example, before topic we know tuberous stem is Brachystelma. Okay, then going to the leaf characters. Before the going to the leaf characters, we have to observe the specialized feature on the stem and also leaves, as well as in on leaves. This feature is glaucus. It's very important character. Glaucus means, what is the definition of the glaucus? On the Asclepiadaceae family plants, on stem and leaves, wax like tomentos. After this topic, I will show the demonstration. This glaucus. Glaucus means wax like tomentos is present on the stem and leaves. This wax like tomentos, due to the presence of this wax like tomentos, these plants are glittering and producing of latex. This particular specific specialized wax like tomentos is known as glaucus. What is the advantage to the glaucus? These plants are glittering and producing of latex due to the presence of the glaucus. Okay, this is about the clear information of glaucus and stem characteristics. Next, going to the leaves characters. Leaves are simple leaves. Leaf structure, leaf lamina structure is ellipsoidal in structure, and in pergillaria, commonly in ellipsoid in structure, but in pergillaria plant, chordate in shape of leaves are observed. Then going to the phyllotaxy of leaves, phyllotaxy already in classification we discussed. Phyllotaxy is opposite decusset manner. What is mean by opposite decusset manner? On the stem, at one pair of the leaves are present towards the opposite, and that pair, and above that pair, another pair is present. That pair is alternate to the below leaves. The type of phyllotaxy is known as opposite decusset phyllotaxy. Then these plants are having the reticulate venation because of the dicotyledonic plants. This is complete vegetative characters of the Asclepiadaceae family, included root, stem and leaves. Next, going to the floral characters. From this topic onwards, very interesting topics in the Asclepiadaceae family. In floral characters, first, inflorescence. Inflorescence is cymose umbel inflorescence. In the cymose umbel inflorescence, first on the peduncle, polycarpial or dicarpial cyme is formed. On this polycarpial or dicarpial cyme, in second, on this cyme, monocarpial cyme is erased. This is the inflorescence type cymose umbel observed in the Asclepiadaceae family. Then these flowers are, this umbel is originated from the axillary position. Originated from the axillary position. Axillary nothing but in between the stem or branch and leaf, place is known as axillary position. I will show the demonstration in the demonstration. Next, going to the flower characters. Flowers have bracts, but bracteolates are absent. That's why indicate as EBRF. Bracts are present, so indicate as BR. Bracteolates are absent. That's why indicate as EBRL. Next, every flower has a stalk. So, pedicellate flowers, then complete flower is present. Complete flower nothing but floral parts, overall floral parts are present. That type of flower is known as complete flower, like calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. Then bisexual flower is present, complete along with bisexual flowers due to the presence of androecium, gynoecium. Then actinomorphic flowers. Some are zygomorphic flowers, then hypogynous flowers. This is about the flower structure, flower characters. Next, going to the floral characters in detail explanation in this PPT. Clearly observe, students, all of you. First character of the floral pots is calyx. Calyx is indicate as K. Indicate with K. In calyx, 5 sepals are present. These 5 sepals are gamosepalous and valvate aestivation. Next, corolla. Corolla, 5 petals. Corolla having the 5 petals. These 5 petals are gamopetalous. But these petals are in different colors and very attractive. In Asclepiadaceae family, most of the flowers are very attractive with beautiful colors. So, these beautiful colors of the flowers are attractiveness of the insects for the pollination easily. Okay, these petals are different in colors and attractive. For example, see the pictures, beside pictures. First picture is Cryptostygia. This Cryptostygia has flowers, funnel shaped corolla. Funnel shaped petals are present. Corolla is in modified as funnel shaped. Then going to the next picture, example is Serapagia, Nimmatai in Telugu. This Serapagia, this is flower. This flower petals are modified as flask shape. Okay, these are the beautiful flowers due to the presence of the different colors and attractive petals. Then, in these petals, in this corolla, we have to observe the specialized characters, that is specialized character, that is corollary corona. This corollary corona and also known as cuculae, cuculae. What is the definition of the corollary corona? It's also important character of this family. Corollary corona. Corona nothing but crown like structure. Okay. This crown like structure is absorbed on petals. Some specialized appendages are on petals formed like corona. Formed like nothing but corona, nothing but crown. Okay. That's why this is called as corollary corona. Once again, I'll explain this topic, this definition. Corollary corona, nothing but cuculae, means some specialized appendages or some specialized structures are present on petals formed like a corona. Nothing but crown-like structures. This is called as corollary corona and also known as cuculae. Okay, example is Asclepias, Gymnia and Prosera. Calotropis Prosera. Okay, this is the character of the corolla. Next, going to the Androecium. Androecium nothing but male sex organ. In this Androecium, already we discussed in the classification of the Asclepiaceae family. Androecium. In the Androecium, stamens are present. Stamens number is equal to the S. Petals number are less than the petals number. Petals are 5 in number in S. In this way, stamens also in 5 in numbering. But these stamens are either fused or free. But these stamens are fused with the petals. That's why this phenomenon is known as epipetalous. Example is Calotropis and Cryptostegia. Epipetalous example is Calotropis and Cryptostegia. Next, these stamens are alternative to the petals. In this Androecium also we have to observe the special characters like in petals, like in corolla, cuculae. In this also we have to observe the special characters. Those are the staminal corona and also Gynostegium. Let us discuss about the what is the definitions of the staminal corona and also Gynostegium. First, let us discuss about the staminal corona. Staminal corona nothing but some appendages are present on the staminal tube and make the flower more attractive. That is known as staminal corona. Simply saying, which crown like structure is present on the staminal tube, that is known as the staminal corona. Due to the presence of the staminal corona, the flower makes more attractive with the corollary corona also. But specifically, staminal corona function is to give the mechanical support to the flower. Then, going to the another definition, that is Gynostegium. It is one of the important character in the Androecium. Pronunciate the Gynostegium word, Gynostegium. Gynostegium. In the Androecium, stamens or anthers are fused with the Gynostegium stigma. Stigma is belongs to the Gynostegium part. Anthers, stamens are belongs to the, or anthers are belongs to the Androecium parts. Yes? Okay. These anthers are fused with the Gynostegium part of the stigma. Once again, you can pronunciate the Gynostegium word. Gynostegium means, gyno means Gynostegium, female sex organ. In this female sex organ, stigma is one part of the Gynostegium. Stegium means stamens. Okay. due to the fusion of the stamens with the stigma of the gynoecium, a specialized pentagular structure is formed. That specialized pentagular structure is called as gynoecium. How is the formation of the pentagular structure? Anthers are fused with the stigma. Anthers are belongs to the androecium. Stigma is belongs to the gynoecium. That's why this is called as gynoecium. Okay, students, clear? Then gynoecium. In this gynoecium, like androecium, some parts are present like anthers, filament, and connective, like these stamens. In gynoecium also some parts are here. Those are the ovary, style, stigma. Okay. First one, ovary. Ovary nature is bicarpellate. Already we known in the classification. Bicarpellate. Why it is put in the bicarpellate? Due to the presence of the bicarpellary fused. Okay. This ovary nature is bicarpellary. Two carpels are present. These bicarpels either fused in some plants, either partially fused in some plants. Ovary nature is bicarpellary, fused or partially fused. This bicarpellary ovary is came from the superior ovary. This is the ovary nature. In the style, style is terminal region, located in the terminal region. Then stigma, already I said before topic gynoecium. What is mean by gynoecium? Once remain in your mind, students. Stigma is pentagular in structure or round in structure. Why it is in pentagular in structure? Due to the fusion of the stamens or anthers with the stigma. That's why it is formed as pentagular structure. This pentagular structure is clearly observed in only calotropis species. Then in the stigma character, placentation is marginal. Placentation bicarpellary. Ovary nature is bicarpellary. Yes, in the stigma each ovary is unilacular. Each ovary is unilacular with many ovules. I'll show the picture after completion of this class. Then this is the complete characters, vegetative as well as floral characters of the Asclepiadaceae family. This Asclepiadaceae family is again classified into two subfamilies. Depends upon the pollinium arrangement. What is pollinium? Already we know what is pollen grains. Pollen grains, nothing but these pollen grains are produced from the anthers. Yes? Okay. These pollen grains, when pollen grains are modified as a group-like structure, such group is known as pollinium. Okay. Based on this pollinium arrangement, this Asclepiadaceae family is classified into two subfamilies. Again, those two subfamilies are Periplocaridae. Example is Cryptostegia. Second subfamily is Synencoidae. Example is Calotropis. These two subfamilies are divided based on the arrangement of the pollinium. Okay. Next topic is, I'll discuss the next part. This is Asclepiadaceae family plant, red gillade. Okay. This plant is, this family is commonly called as milkweed family. Why? Because from the stem and leaves producing of the milk-like latex, like this milk-like latex called as, this family is called as Milky Way family. Then from this stem, on the stem and on the leaves, this is wax. See this. This is wax. Okay. This wax. This is wax. On the stem also white wax. Here, this is wax, ma. Okay. This wax is present on the stem and leaves also. That's why this is called as, this wax is called as glaucus. This glaucus, due to the presence of the glaucus, it is useful for the withering of the stem and leaves. So then another demonstration is, once absorb this twig, this is phyllotaxy. This phyllotaxy is opposite decussate phyllotaxy. See this twig once. This is one node. This nodal region of the leaves are opposite one to another. This is one pair of the leaves. Above this pair of the leaf, another pair is present. This another pair is alternative to below pair of the leaves. These are again opposite to one to another. Again, on these leaves, opposite. In this way, leaves are arranged on the stem. Such type of phenomenon is known as, such type of phyllotaxy is known as opposite decussate manner of phyllotaxy. Then, floral characters. This type of inflorescence is, cymose umbel inflorescence. This is cymose umbel inflorescence. Umbel nothing but umbrella. This is entire cluster, cluster formation of the, group formation of the flowers are present at the apical region of the twig. Such type of phenomenon is, such type of inflorescence type is known as a cymose umbel inflorescence. In the cymose umbel inflorescence, flowers are arranged from the axil pot. I show the axil pot. This is axil pot. Axil pot means in between the branch and also leaf. This is leaf, this is branch. In between the leaf and branch, this pot is, this pot is known as axil pot. From this axil pot, inflorescence is produced. Okay, this is leaf axil pot. Then going to the flower, I'll take a flower. This is umbel. I'll take flower. Each and every flower has a large petiole. If petiole is present, the flower is known as a pedicellate or petiolate. This is complete flower. I'll take one flower from this umbel. This is single flower. In this flower, we have to observe the overall pods. Those are the calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. See this flower. This 5 pods are observed below region of the flower, I mean reverse. These 5 are sepals. See this clearly observed sepals, 5 sepals. This is outer oval of the flowers. This oval is known as a calyx, ma. How many in numbering of the calyx sepals? These are the sepals in green in color. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, these are the sepals. Next, see this ones from leaf flower petiole also given the latex here. Latex, milky like latex. Okay, Then these are the sepals, 5 in number. Next I'll show the petals. These are the petals, ma. These 5 petals, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the 5 petals. And each and every petal, it's very beautiful flower. Once observed here, these are the crown-like structure. These are the petals. Above region of the petals, crown-like structures also present. It is curved shape. This is curved shape. It is every petal above region. Curved shaped structures are present. These curved shaped structures are known as, it is appearance like a crown to the petal. Yes, it is appearance like a crown to the petal. And the each petal, it is appearance like a crown. That's why this crown like structure is known as a corollary corona.